In 2024, David Baker shared the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for work related to protein design, which is the process of synthesizing new and novel proteins.
The work we're doing sort of roughly falls into three general areas. So the first is medicine, the second is energy and sustainability, and the third is sort of new technology.
To design a new protein, researchers in Baker's lab select a molecular target. Their goal is to create a protein that binds to this target's shape. First, the target shape is fed into a generative AI system called RF diffusion. In the same way that algorithms like DALL-E generate images from prompts, RF diffusion generates protein structure backbones that mold to the form of the target shapes.
We can start with completely random noise and progressively denoise it, and we end up with something that looks like a perfectly plausible protein structure, but in fact is completely new.
Once the diffusion algorithm generates a 3D model of the protein structure, another piece of software determines which amino acid sequences could potentially fold into the given structure. While there are many solutions to this puzzle, not all of them will work. So the sequences are fed into a prediction AI like AlphaFold 2 to confirm which candidates will likely fold as designed. The last piece of software determines the DNA sequence which will produce the given amino acid sequence inside a cell. This DNA sequence is sent to a lab to be synthesized.
If we're making brand new proteins, there are no genes that encode them. So we have to make synthetic genes that encode these proteins.
Researchers then introduce the synthetic gene fragment into bacteria, which produce the protein.
The bacteria basically become factories which make the proteins.
In the final step, imaging techniques like cryo-EM are used to confirm whether the shape of the protein produced in the lab is the same as the one predicted by the computer.
We can now design proteins which are much more sophisticated and should be much more precise and safe. Beyond medicine, we're working on improved methods of capturing sunlight and doing things with that energy. We're working on improved methods for degrading toxic compounds.